Woodblock printing is, in my opinion, one of the most beautiful mediums in visual arts. But before we begin, let's make a bench hook for our blocks out of 12mm plywood. Use your circular saw and the table saw to cut your pieces to size. Here I glue and nail all my pieces together. And that's how it works. As you carve against the block, it hooks on the bench. You can use boxwood as a block because it's really nice to carve. But I think plywood is a better choice. It has less chances to warp and provides a really flat printing surface. You can use linoleum gouges or carving chisels for this work. This is my sharpening stone and my strop. You want really sharp tools, so have your sharpening system close to you. My primary tool is the skew chisel. You cut from one side at an angle and then you cut from the other to create a V groove. You can also hollow tight spots. Always come at an angle. Remove material with multiple passes. Don't force the wood or the tool. It's a good idea to coat your block with ink, so when you remove material, you reveal the light areas. The V chisel also creates V grooves, but I find the skew more accurate. You can also take advantage of the gouges shapes to cut circles. The gouges also help to remove material fast. Draw the form you want with a pencil and carve it out. The thumb can help as a brake. This way you have better control over the tool. Once you finish with the skew, clean up with a gouge. This is an improvised piece, so I draw, then I carve until I am satisfied with the result. The skew is really accurate, as long as you take your time with it, especially with such a small carving project. It's really impressive when the light spots start revealing the image. Next stop, the mountains. Here I remove material halfway and then I come from the back to finish the job. I wanted the clouds really fragile. This was the most difficult part. I tried my best to make them as good as possible. And that's the result so far. At this point, I resharpened my chisel. And I did a few fine tunings on my block. For printing, you must use a special paper. It must absorb moisture nicely. You will also need Linoprint water-based ink, a spatula, a roller. This tool to press the paper against the block. And a flat surface like plexiglass or glass. Next, add some ink, spread it with a spatula and fill the roller. Ink your block with the roller, put your paper in place and start printing. The first couple of prints were awful. The third came out better. I kept experimenting by spraying water on my paper before printing. This seemed to help the paper absorb the ink better. Adding a second paper on top of the print seemed to also help in the process. I believe this is something on which you improve with practice. As a printer, you should number your prints. As you print, the ink fills the shallowest areas of the block, but they still show up on paper. And that's a mistake. My signature should have been carved backwards. In this printing session, I created 24 prints. I will keep this one because the black is vivid. I like those because I printed the brand of the paper by accident. I like the texture on these too. And basically, that's the nice thing about this process. Everything is different and has its own unique character. This is the 19th print out of a total of 24. If you want to keep it, you sign it. Woodblock printing is awesome. It creates unique pieces and can offer you hours of creative fun. I hope you enjoyed this project as much as I did. But that was it. See you soon with a new project video.